Hi everybody, this is Byron Jacobs for everymanchess.com. In this short video I'm going to be talking about a new book on the Sicilian Scheveningen by the author Lorin D'Costa. This is a book in our Move by Move series, and if you want more information about the structure of the books in this series, please look at another video on the site which deals specifically with that topic. This book obviously deals with the Sicilian Scheveningen mainly from Black's point of view, although it would also be a useful book for players who play 1e4 as white and may run into this system. Essentially, Lorin D'Costa looks at all the possible white replies to the Scheveningen and suggests ways that Black can counter them. If we look at the contents page of the book here, you can see here how he deals with each of the particular variations. There's the Bishop E2 lines, which also arrive from the Nydorf move order, the Keres attack with G4, the English attack with Bishop E3, normally followed up with F3, Queen D2 and G4. There's Bishop C4 as favoured by Fischer in his heyday, quieter variations with G3 and F4, and then other sixth moves. There is a whole chapter on the start on Kasparov on the Scheveningen, as obviously Kasparov has been one of the main players as Black of the Scheveningen system over the last two or three decades, and has added much to the theory, and has also played many brilliant games with the Scheveningen, and so this chapter focuses on Kasparov's contributions to the theory and practice of the Scheveningen variation. As you will know, these books deal in a kind of question and answer format, in to the extent that the reader is encouraged to pause periodically and consider a question that has been set by the author, and then think about what they try to do in response, thus trying to mimic what actually happens when you're playing a game. And I want to look at a couple of points now from this game, which is Movsesian Kasparov from Sarajevo 2000, where D'Costa sets you a couple of things to think about as we watch Kasparov handle the Scheveningen on the black side in his usual decisive manner. I'll just flick through the opening moves of the game quickly. It's obviously a normal Scheveningen. It starts off as a Nydorf, but quickly transposes to the Scheveningen after the Bishop E3 move, and White adopts what is known as the English attacking formation. Black manoeuvres round onto the king side, and I want to just pause at this position and flick back to the book. Now here you're not actually asked to find Black's next move, which is the standard Sicilian exchange sacrifice, rook takes c3. What the author wants you to think about, you can see down here, is why can Black get away with such a move? So he's not always asking you to look for tactical ideas. As this example shows, he's asking you to think strategically and positionally about the situation on the board and try to decide what the strategic and positional themes are in the position that allow Black to make this sacrifice. Hopefully this is a very effective way to learn an opening, because you're not just trying to memorise by rote a sequence of moves, you're actually encouraged to think about the important strategic factors in the position. And the answer that the author provides can be seen below. Essentially, the ideas are that Black will almost certainly regain the pawn on c3 and can attack very fluidly on the queen side with moves such as knight a4. Now we're going to move on to a position a little bit later on in the game. We'll just flick through the sequence. Rook takes c3, b takes, and now you'll see Black developing fluidly, as has been described in the explanations as to how he can get away with this. The very important move, knight a4, the knight's very threatening on that square against the fractured white queen side. And now White is obviously beginning to get a little bit of counterplay by himself on the king side, and after the following sequence we reach this position. And if we flick back to the book, you'll see that this position is chosen by the author for a question asking how would you proceed here as Black. Obviously White's angling to play g6, and he is an exchange up. Black must act quickly, so you need to think hard about how Black can proceed with his own play. And the solution here is that rather than capturing on c3, which allows White to consolidate to a certain extent, Black rips open further lines on the queen side with b4. And I'll just show you quickly the rest of the game on on the screen, you can see that black doesn't bother recapturing on b4. He's just angling to get his pieces into the white king-queen side as quickly as possible. And now there's a nice sacrifice, which completely destroys the white position. As if he captures the bishop here, you'll see that bishop e5 check completely finishes white off, because he no longer has the response d4. White thrashes around a bit, but Kasparov, as you would expect, tidies up without too much trouble. So hopefully that will give you a good flavour of the book, the variations and the structure, and some ideas of the content and what it's all about. This book is The Sicilian Scheveningen, Move by Move. The author is Lorin D'Costa. It will be available in UK and Europe in March 2012, and in the US it will be available in May 2012. This has been Byron Jacobs for EverymanChess.com.